family and our faith in God, just being brought up religious, we were very unselfish people, very caring, gentle-hearted people. And I think that that good common horse sense has really helped me in my business transactions through the years. And I don't, to me, Hollywood is no different than anywhere else. If there's bull, no matter where you go, in any form of business, it don't have to be just show business. But I really feel like that I'm at home anywhere I am, so I'm never threatened or intimidated at all by the people, because there's a lot of real and good people in Hollywood. Like, we always just hear that it's like a terrible place, but it's really not. You, like I say, there's a lot of phonies there, but I've known a lot of phonies.
Are you the oldest girl?
No, I have one sister, Willadine, who's the oldest one of the family. My sister Willadine also had a book out. She did a lot of television things last year. A lot of you might have seen her. She has a book out called In the Shadow of a Song. And so she wrote a book about the Parton family. And she's the oldest, and I have two brothers in between then me.
You must have gotten your independent... You have a very good self-image. I mean, you like yourself.
Yeah, I do.
Well, isn't that about childhood? Were your folks approving of you, or was there a lot of don't, shouldn't, can't, spanking kind of, I'm trying to figure out?
Well, I think one good thing about growing up in a big family and growing up in the mountains, we didn't have, Mama and Daddy just pretty much left us to grow up the way we were. They didn't have the time, first of all, like we said earlier, to discipline each one. We really were disciplined. Mama was real lenient, and Daddy was strict, so that made for a real good balance. But they didn't whip us for no reason. We really had to be in trouble to get it. And Mama was always, like I've always told her, she had one in her and one on her for as long as we remember. But no disrespect, because she was always pregnant. So she was, the older ones had to take care of the others. And we didn't have to worry about trains and cars, because we lived way back in the mountains. So we were just left to kind of grow up and have our own individual personalities.
Right. What did your father do?
My father was a farmer, still is, for all of his life. But as we started to multiply and to grow, then he went to work on construction. So he's worked on construction work for extra money, and we've always raised our own food.
And your folks survive. They're living?
Oh, yeah. My mother's only 60, and Daddy's 62 right now. We're a very young family.
Well, how have their lives changed because of their daughter Dolly's success?
Well, they're very proud of me, but a lot of people say, well, I bet your folks are so proud of you. Mom and Daddy always had a way of never making difference in any of us. I mean, they're just as proud of all of my brothers and sisters as they are me, but they are especially proud because I have done well. They're proud for me, not just of me. They're proud that I've been successful at what I really wanted to do, because I drove everybody crazy all of my life to do this. So they're really happy, you know, to see that things have gone well.
Now, did you get him into an air-conditioned condo? I mean, this is none of our business.
Well, I take care of my folks, and my folks had such a hard time raising us when we were growing up. We had some really bad times, but the only thing I regret about my childhood is the fact that Mom and Daddy had such a hard time, but they never did complain. And as long as I make a dime, then Mom and Daddy's got a nickel. If they need the dime, they can have that, too.
And we'll be back in just a moment. Rogers and Dolly Parton at work. I tell you this, you're an inspiration. And I know your folks must be very proud of you. Let me say again that Dollywood opens May 3rd in the Gatlinburg area, about 25 miles from Knoxville.
Yeah, and I brought you a free pass. Free season pass. I'm serious, I really did.
All right.
So you can come anytime that you want to. I'm real excited about it. The park, I think I mentioned earlier, but I'm going to mention it again, because it opens in May and it goes through October. So we're going to have all summer, and it's like you'd mentioned before, since we can't go to Europe, come to Sevier County.
You could probably fall in love in this park.
In love up there.
Are you there? I'm glad you waited. Hi.
Yes, I am. I'm a fan of Dolly's, and I'd like to let her know that she makes the trashy and the gaudy look beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you design your own clothes, or do you have a favorite designer?
Well, I design a lot of the clothes, because I've never been a real stylish person. I just wear what I feel is right for me, because I'm very short, and I'm kind of out of proportion. So I have to kind of wear certain things, or I like to wear certain things. But I have some designers that work, especially on certain television shows or for the movies, I have designers.
Yes,
but otherwise, that's just...
Yes, Dolly, I'd like to ask you, if you work with aspiring talent coming up, or do you work with any organizations for any people that are coming up in the country music now?
Well, that's a good question. Are you trying to get in the business? Yeah. How are you? But I do try very hard to work with young people. Like I mentioned before, a lot of my own brothers and sisters and uncles and aunts and cousins, I try to work very close with them. And a lot of them are going to be working in Dollywood. And I've always had a publishing company where I've tried to encourage young writers and everything. I don't have an organization set up for it. But we are certainly more than happy to listen to songs and all. But I wish you good luck, too.
You do so many things. How do you manage time?
Well, it's because this is like a way of life with me. A lot of people say, you're so into so much, so many irons in the fire. I never really think of it like that. It's because I enjoy every day, and it's not something I feel like I have to get done every day. And I just come up with ideas, and I don't like being bored, and hopefully I'll always have enough projects to do. So there seems to always be time. As they always say, you make time for the things that you really want to do.
Yeah. I want to say I'm very impressed with you. You're very different from the preconceived image I've had of you, and you're lovely. You're very disarming and natural. And one quick question: what is there left in your life, in your career, to do that you feel you haven't done?
Well, that's a good question, and thank you very much for the compliment. I have a lot of things I want to do, and a lot of times I've noticed with the big ideas that come to me, they just come out of nowhere, because I always try to set new goals. But one of the things that I hope to make more movies, I hope to become a bigger recording artist to sell more records. I've had a lot of hit records, but never like been consistent where I have one hit after another. So I hope to make some better records and become a bigger artist, a better writer. And I just signed a book deal with Simon & Schuster, and I'm going to start writing some books. So we mentioned it a little earlier, the one that at the moment the title of it is called Going For It. That may change later, but it's still, when you hear about a book being out, it'll be that same book. So I want to get more involved in business things. I just started a production company for television and for the movies, and hopefully good things will come from that.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you plan to make another special with Kenny Rogers soon?
Well, I don't know what I will do with Kenny in the future as far as television, but Kenny Rogers is one of the greatest people that I have ever known in my life. I mean, he's more than you can imagine. He's always been so nice to me, so good to me, and his group on the road, I work a lot of concerts with him. They've always been good. And when we did our Christmas special together, it's some of the best times that I've ever had working with another entertainer. He's very honest, very talented. And we're trying to find another duet song now that we can record together and have another big hit like we did with Islands in the Stream. But I sure hope that the future holds more things for us.
Yes, sir.
How has feminism touched your life?
Well, I feel that I have always been very fortunate that I have, like I said, been a woman. I've always been fortunate that I have been treated with respect. I've always tried to treat myself with respect and never allowed people to just run over me because I was a woman. And I think that anybody that's capable of doing a job, whether you be male or female, black, white, green, or blue, I think that you should be allowed to do whatever you can. I think everybody has a right to express themselves. And I have had less problems with it than a lot of people seem to.
Are you there? Hi.
Yes. Being well endowed as you are, have you ever been asked to pose nude, and would you?
Well, as a matter
of
fact...
No, I never...
I actually was asked to pose a nude once in Playboy magazine back a few years ago when they were, like, offering big money for a lot of the celebrities. And they offered me... I think it was Playboy or Hustler, one of those magazines. And they offered me $1 million to do it. And there's no way in the world that I would do that. So, I mean, I was flattered in a way, although it was like, but it was also insulting in a way. But still, I thought, well, You know, if I ever really got desperate and needed $1 million, maybe I could still do it, but I better do it soon.
Hi, are you there? Go ahead.
Yes, Dolly, this is Vicki King from Knoxville, and I'm a singer,
hey.
Too. And when you come home to Sevierville, do you find it a problem to go and shop and do things that you want to do without people recognizing you or bothering you?
Well, I usually, when I get a chance to come home, which I was up there yesterday, as a matter of fact, I just left Sevierville yesterday, I don't usually go shopping up there that much. When I go home, I usually go to visit Mom and Daddy and my brothers and sisters and just friends in the area. But people up there know me. I know that they know me, and I've even built a little park so they'll be sure to know me. So I don't mind. I love the people up there. And it's nice to talk to somebody from home.
If you were able to have children, do you think your career today might be different?
Well, that's a good question. I don't know for sure. It's like I've always enjoyed what I've done. I think that I would have been a good mother if I'd have had children. But I think I would have probably continued with show business. I think the child would have probably just known that's what I do, and I'd have tried to have involved my children as much as I could have in my life and to still keep them balanced and wholesome, but that's a good question. At least if I can't have children, I feel like I'm out there doing something to entertain your children.
If there is a movie made of your life, who would you like to see play you?
Me.
Dolly, first let me say you look incredible in person.
Thank you.
But do you have any plans in the future to tour with other country stars like Kenny Rogers?
Well, I am going to do some more things with Kenny. As you know, last year I spent the biggest part of my touring days, with the exception of the Golden Nugget in Las Vegas and Atlantic City, which I'll be in Atlantic City this weekend, by the way. But I do hope to work some more with Kenny and with some of the other artists.
And we'll be back in a moment.
Bye.
I've lost control of my own program.
Just write your name. Thank you.
Okay.
Let me show you Dolly in high school.
Are you serious?
Yeah, look at this.
See that hair? That was not a wig.
That was you. That's your real hair, and you still have it.
Oh, and that was, what's that? Oh, that's at the... Oh, that's our...
senior prom?
I sold most donuts that year. That's my senior class.
Yeah. Next slide.
We made up money for our senior trip, which we came to New York at the World's Fair.
Look at your glamour
the
puss
World's Fair.
Here. Yeah,
well,
they haven't changed, they're saying.
Thank you.
Hi, are you there? I'm glad you waited.
Yes, I am.
Okay. Yeah.
I think Dolly's terrific, and I'd just like to know whether she's intimidated by any person or anything.
Well, not really. I really like people, and like we mentioned before, I have respect for myself as well as for other people, and I don't feel I need to be intimidated. I try to work through whatever problems I have, and if somebody has a real problem with me and they'll give me a chance to work it out with them, then I try to do that. But no, I'm pretty content with who I am. 1 minute.
Dolly, what was it like to work with Sylvester Stallone?
I liked working with Sylvester Stallone. A lot of people have asked me that. Although the movie Rhinestone was a big flop, I thought the project itself was a success because he's a real nice guy. He's very bright, very clever, very funny, and he's very talented, and he was very good to me. So he's certainly pretty to look at, so it made the days enjoyable.
Dolly, we like your honesty. Any plans on doing a dramatic role ever?
Well, I'd like to do a dramatic role. Most people that are sending me scripts these days are still looking at me like the, you know, the blonde, the boobs and the hair and, you know, all that. But I am looking for something good because I'd be willing to come the look down and, you know, wear different hair and, you know, take off the nails and the heels and stuff if I needed to, if it was the right project.
Over here, Dolly.
Which do you enjoy better, writing songs or performing in front of an audience?
I think writing songs is my favorite thing that I do in the whole world because it's the way I express myself, it's the way I express life, and so I think songwriting is wins out.
Okay, I was wondering, where do you get your ideas for your lyrics?
From everybody, from my own life and from the lives of, you know, the people that I know and love.
Yeah. Dolly, how tall are you?
Don't forget Dollywood opens May 3rd, not far from Knoxville in the Gatlinburg area. Dolly's got her name on a roller coaster. That's something. On the whole park, yeah.
Dolly, I'd like to ask you, are you politically involved in any movements in this country? Like
well, I certainly have my opinions about a lot of
services
things, but I try
provided
not to
and
get
promotional
involved
fees paid
politically
by the following.
As far as the press.